Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot. Welcome back to Jurassic World Evolution 2, our Mod Spotlight series, our final Mod Spotlight series before the Jurassic World Dominion Malta expansion comes out in a few days' time. Now, that means a very good time for a disclaimer. Mods can possibly do some damage to your game, break save files and stuff like that. It is rare, but we should talk about it. Especially with an update coming out. Personally, I will clear every single mod from my game files before I install a new update when it comes out. So I would recommend that for basically everyone. And then after that, you can go and see which mods are going to work post-update in a safe and responsible manner. If mods do break your game, however, it's not my fault, it's not Frontier's fault, and it's not the mod maker's fault. Asmodeus is not here today, he's away watching the football, which is currently on and I'm very sad. he's supporting Italy, I haven't had the heart to, you know, to tell him. So, let's get started. It's a pretty low-key day today, we've just got five little mods to look at. Well, not little mods, five great mods to look at, but five mods to look at. You know, with an update on the way, people are always a little bit hesitant because you never know what's going to happen post-update. It's exciting and nerve-wracking at the same time. I'm going to have to kill some of these trees because they're bad trees. So, let's get started with our first dinosaur, Nanuchosaurus. Made by Rommel Hines, one of my personal favourite dinosaurs, so already very cool to see this come to life in Evolution 2. Even cooler, actually, to see it come to life in Evolution 2, because of course, we now have snowy maps and stuff like that that we could possibly take advantage of. Before we talk about it, Nanuchosaurus is a tyrannosaurid from late Cretaceous Alaska. Nanuk coming from a native Alaskan word for polar bear, which is, you know, awesome. Nanuk is pretty small, as you can see, for what it is, which is an advanced tyrannosaurid. And that's really probably just because of the lack of food in those Alaskan winters, and it wouldn't be able to sustain a larger carnivore. Funnily enough, however, Troodon, which also lived in this same rough region, we're not going to get into the Troodon debate right now, but Troodon living in the same region, it was actually 50% larger in this same region than it was with its southern counterparts. And that's probably just so it had like a larger eye socket and stuff like that, so we could see better in those dark Alaskan winters. Right, anyways, Rommel Hines has made a fantastic Nanuchosaurus. It's using, okay, I'm trying to find, I don't like that obviously, but that's okay. I'm just trying to get a good view. It looks really good. The entire body is feathered. Some of it is just kind of built into the texture, as you can see, but some of it, like here at the back of the head and around the skull, is actively feathered in the way that we'd love to see. That is really, really cool. It looks fantastic. Good stuff. Really starting off strong today, and we're going to continue that with an ACHILLOBATOR. Okay, I'm going to assume this is based on the Pyroraptor rig. So this is ACHILLOBATOR based, made by HyperSGYT, a late Cretaceous Asian dromaeosaurid. A bit of a beast in reality. This was a thickly built, heavy creature. Not built for speed and maneuverability in the way that other dromaeosaurids were, but more for strength and large prey hunting. It likely would have been, in reality, entirely feathered. It would have been a fully feathered dinosaur, but we're in a Jurassic game here, and I actually think this kind of, the feathering at the back of the head, at the side of the head there, sort of on the under bit of the jaw, we've got a little bit there at the back of the arms as well, at the elbow kind of section. It kind of is a nice fusion of those two aspects. It definitely looks like a dinosaur you'd see in like Jurassic Park 3 or something, you know? And you can see by the body shape here, it's a very thick, husky, thick with two C's kind of dinosaur. But yeah, I mean, looks really good. Really like the patterning as well. It's very subtle, but you know, kind of sparks up a little bit here on the skull, as you can see. Just yeah, really nicely made dinosaur. Really cool to have another dromaeosaurid in the game. We kind of lack for them actually a little bit. And HyperSGYT has done a fantastic job as always. We have a couple of remakes or rejigs or something like that. I'm going to do the Megalosaurus first. So let's check this A Better Megalosaurus by Master Doot. Hey, Just a very small change for the Megalosaurus, and it's going to be up to personal opinion, but it's an attempt to make it a little bit more realistic. The main thing that's been done is, of course, the snout has been elongated quite dramatically. Gives it a little bit less of a pug face, somewhat. And it brings it more in line with what a Megalosaurus would likely have looked like. This is very personal opinion. If you think it looks better, you can use it, and you'll have a bit more paleo accuracy, and you'll have a big long face, which everybody wants. If you don't want to use it, you don't want to use it, but it's been done well. Kind of fits the dinosaur perfectly. Very much could have seen it released like this, and I don't think anyone would have had any complaints, which is a sign of a good mod. So shout out to Master Dude for that one. Not too much to say about the remake ones, obviously. We're going to check out another one now. This is the Giga remake by Mr. Troodon. It will be when this Nanooksaurus gets out of the way. There we go. Maybe. So the idea of here, of course, is to still have it look like the Jurassic World Dominion Giga. It's still got all the telltale signs of the Jurassic World Dominion Giga, but it looks a lot more realistic and some of the more extraneous features have been toned down. I do have a comparison image up, so we can actually talk about what's being done. I do want to say I hope this mod works post-update, or I hope this mod gets updated post-update, because having this slightly more realistic interpretation, or much more realistic interpretation, along with those new Giga skins, which already make the dinosaur look a lot more naturalistic and realistic, that's going to be a really, really cool combination, and we could end up with a pretty awesome looking dinosaur. Anyways, let's talk about it. So obviously the hump, crest, spike thing here has been toned down. All the spikes are still here and still present, but the huge bit here, which was the most egregious section of the design, has been toned down and kind of just brought in line with the rest of the dinosaur. I think the body's been lowered a little bit. The tail has her kink in it now, as you can see here. This used to be very, very straight and a bit lower down, but now it has a little boop, boop kink at the back. We've got a dewlap. I love a dewlap. The crest is more uppity, I suppose is the word I'm going to give you here. The crest is more forcefully vertical. There you go, more forcefully vertical. The spikes here are actually a little bit bigger, a little bit more spread out. The mouth has been shrunk down a little bit and brought forward in terms of where the sort of this bit starts. And we've got this little kink here as well on the chin, which has been made a lot stronger. And it looks really good. It looks, it actually looks pretty fantastic. It looks more recognizably like a Giga, but it still retains that Dominion nature. And you know what? This always really annoys me. And this obviously isn't Frontier's fault. This is very much a Universal Design Team kind of thing. If you could have the dinosaur look like this and be more in line with the real dinosaur, I don't think anyone would argue that this loses anything compared to what we got in Jurassic World Dominion, right? So why not just do this in the first place? You know? Like, why Just do a few different things. I felt the same about the Pyroraptor, which just a couple of changes. It wouldn't have taken away from the design, but it would have pleased a lot more people. I don't know. Anyways, good work there. Shout out to Mr. Troodon. These two are going to be best of friends. We have one more mod to take a look at. This is a Postosuchus. Wait, no, I always do that. Yeah, I always want to call it Postosuchus, but it's Postosuchus, I believe. This is a Postosuchus mod by a Lego Craft Boy with help from Near01 and Sweetener. Based on Herrerasaurus, like every other mod on the planet. But yeah, very, very cool. So Postosuchus is a, I'm going to butcher this so hard, Rauisukid from Late Jurassic North America. And these are basically large, oh my god, large predatory archosaurs. Already I saw a comment on the mod page about this, but they were debated for a long time about whether they were bipedal or quadrupedal. But bipedal definitely seems to have won the day. It's been a long time since people actively argued that Postosuchus was quadrupedal, but then again, as I say, there were already comments on Nexus mods going, shouldn't it be quadrupedal? But I believe the current scientific consensus is very much a bipedal. These front limbs were 64% of the size of the back limbs, which already suggests bipedal movement. But not just that, but the proportions of these hind limbs and the spine in this area in particular were very similar to other, well, not other, but large bipedal theropods that would have come later on as the dinosaurs started to take over. So, you know, the proportions of the giga in that sort of back hind limb section are not necessarily dissimilar to the Postosuchus, which of course suggests bipedal movement like the theropods. Really interesting looking creature, of course, absolutely bizarre, and that's always one of my favorite things to see in a mod. So, this went on way longer than intended for 5 mods, but some really cool stuff today. I really want to see this Giga mod post-update, I'm really hoping it works. We never know for sure what updates are going to do to mods. They could break them, they could be totally okay. You know, I really recommend everyone, yeah, I'm going to do it probably tonight. Everyone just clears out all their mod stuff and, you know, have a fresh install. I'm just going to full-on fresh install the game, ready for the update, as I usually do. And then you can go back and get your mods again and stuff like that. This becomes a lot easier to manage, of course, when the game is finished updating. And we've got some plans for how I'm going to do that. And we'll go back to our dinosaur species list and all that. I think Francis scored. Anyways, thank you very much for joining me. Go give these mod makers lots of love. Of course, you can download all of these from a link in the description. You'll see a mod spotlight document that's got all the links for all the mod spotlights I've done so far. And that's it from me. So thank you very much for joining me. Come back later this week, of course, for tons of content on the Dominion Malta expansion. And I'll see you lovely folks there. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much of as always. I think I said that 3 times now. Bye bye. Reaching out.